India has an amazingly wide spectrum of animals native to the country. Despite the various environmental issues faced, the country still has a rich and varied wildlife. Charismatic mammals are important for wildlife tourism, and several national parks and wildlife sanctuaries cater to these needs. Among these national parks and wildlife sanctuaries across the nation, some extremely rare and endangered wildlife dwells in Gujarat. Gujarat, with its varied topography, is a storehouse of biological diversity and commands a myriad species of flora and fauna. This absolutely vivacious state is one of the wealthiest wildlife destinations in the country, along with some other valued species protected in Gujarat. The Asiatic lions are found in the Gir National Park, the wild ass in the Little Run of Kutch, the rare great Indian bustard in the bird reserves, and the black bucks in Vilavdar, Bhavnagar. Sloth bear is another important contribution to the wildlife of Gujarat. It is found in Balaram Ratna Mahal and Jambu Ghoda wildlife sanctuaries. Some of the important wildlife destinations are national parks like Gir Forest, Vilavdar Black Buck, Marine National Park, and Vanstha National Parks and sanctuaries like Wild Ass, Nal Sarovar, Jasor Sloth Bear, Hingolgad Narayan Sarovar, Khijariya, Ratna Mahal Sloth Bear, Kutch Desert, Gaga, Rampara, Shulpaneshwar, Porbandar, Balaram, Ambaji, Jambu Ghoda, and Great Indian Bustard Sanctuaries and Kutch Biosphere Reserve. As we move towards the western side of the state, we come across the world's only abode of Asiatic lions. The park is located about 65 kilometers southeast of the Junagadh district of Gujarat, and features lush deciduous forest, acacia shrubs, and grasslands, which forms the part of the diverse topography of the sanctuary. Set up in a vast, expansive space of nearly 1,412 square kilometers, the Gir National Park is one of India's best known and prestigious national parks. Inaugurated on the 18th of September 1965, the park was made the principal home to Asiatic lions, one of the rare species of lions that are found in India and parts of the Middle East. It is the sizable population of these lions that has made Gir one of the most popular national parks in India and has also perked up Gujarat tourism. The king of the jungle strolls around in this protected forest without any peril. Seeing this majestic cat moving about here is a wildlife enthusiast's lifetime experience. Gir is also one of the most beautiful national parks in the country, with the distinctive landscape comprising of rugged ridges, isolated hills, plateaus and valleys. The best time to visit Gir National Park is between December and mid-June. Gujarat is a paradise for bird watchers and wildlife enthusiasts. Deciduous forests, desert plains, grasslands make the state one of the most pleasant places for wildlife viewing. At the Vilavadar Black Buck National Park, one can sight a sizable population of black bucks. The park is situated in the Bhavnagar district of Gujarat and is spread over an area of about 34 square kilometers. Velavadar is a flat, grassy area where herds of black bucks are often seen loitering around. This park is home to approximately 3,000 black bucks. The best time to visit Velavadar Black Buck National Park is between July and March. Apart from black bucks, this national park is the secure habitat for the endangered Indian wolf, jackal, Indian fox, jungle cat, bluebill antelope, and other animals. The forests exist in a very delicate ecological balance where the health of a forest depends on the health of every member that is a part of its food chain. Vansthar National Park is amongst the most popular wildlife reserves in Gujarat. The park is situated in the Navsari district and is spread across a small area of 23 square kilometers. However, do not be fooled by its small size, as Vansthar is known for sheltering a large wildlife population. With River Ambika snaking through the forest and the thickets of woods make this place quite a pleasing sight to see. The area is characteristically rich in floral diversity, particularly medicinal plants. It has numerous floral and faunal species of global conservation significance. The best time to visit Vansthar National Park is between November and March. The state's first captive deer breeding park, set up at Vansthar National Park, is a facility set up with the aim of breeding, reintroduction and conservation of deer and antelope in the forests. This project helps to restore food chain and decreases the human-wild animal conflicts. Deers are collected from zoos around the state and transferred to Vansthar Deer Park in special deer breeding centers. Once they grow up, they are released into the forest. This helps to improve the food chain, which was badly jeopardized in the region.
हमारे यहाँ पे 2000 से अधिक टॉप कार्निवोर्स हैं, जिसमें से 523 जैसे सिंह हैं, 600 से अधिक यहाँ पे लेपर्ड्स पाए जाते हैं, 1000 से अधिक यहाँ पे क्रोकोडाइल्स पाए जाते हैं। इससे अधिक अगर हम बात करें जो सह अस्तित्व है यहाँ पे जिस प्रकार से जो हमारे वन्य प्राणी हैं हमारे लोगों के साथ यहाँ पे रह रहे हैं वो एक सबसे बड़ा उदाहरण है आज सह अस्तित्व का वाइल्ड लाइफ और ह्यूमन बींग्स का पूरे अगर विश्व की बात करूँ तो पूरे विश्व में हम कह सकते हैं कि ये वन ऑफ द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल है जहां पे जो शेरों की संख्या बहुत कम रह गई थी 20वीं शताब्दी के शुरुआत में इस सह अस्तित्व की वजह से ही आज हमारी जो शेरों की संख्या है वो लगातार बढ़ रही है और आज 2015 की गणना के मुजब 523 शेर हमारे यहाँ पे हो गए हैं।
Reckoned to be one of the smallest wildlife sanctuaries in India, Kutch Great Indian Bustard Sanctuary is located in Nalia in Kutch district. As the name suggests, this sanctuary conserves the Great Indian Bustard, which has an ostrich-like appearance. Once common on the dry plains of the Indian subcontinent, now the species is critically endangered by hunting and loss of its habitat, which consists of large expanses of dry grassland and scrub. A large bird with horizontal body and long bare legs, this bird is amongst the heaviest of the flying birds. The Great Indian Bustard is a large ground bird with a height of about 1 meter. It is unmistakable, with its black cap contrasting with the pale head and neck. The body is brownish, with a black patch spotted in white. The Great Indian Bustard is omnivorous. Apparently, insects consisting mainly of Orthoptera, but also beetles, are preferred in the diet. Alternatively, they will take grass, seeds, berries, rodents and reptiles. The best time to visit Kutch Great Indian Bustard Sanctuary is between August and March. Current threats to the species include the development of linear infrastructure intrusion such as roads and electric power lines in the desert that lead to collision-related mortality. Located on what is called the Little Run of Kutch, Wild Ass Sanctuary is the only wildlife reserve for the last Indian wild ass in India. It is one of the largest sanctuaries in Gujarat. Most of the area of the sanctuary is grassland, which is also called bait. The Indian wild ass, also called the good kur or kur in the local Gujarati language, is a subspecies of the onagar, native to southern Asia. As of 2016, it is listed as endangered by IUCN. Known for its stamina and surprising speed, they can run at 24 km per hour for 2 hours and take that to 70 km per hour in sprints. It is one of the fastest of Indian animals, with speeds clocked at about 70 to 80 km per hour, and can easily outrun a jeep. The Indian wild ass, as with most other Asian wild ass subspecies, is quite different from the African wild ass species. The coat is usually sandy, but varies from reddish grey, fawn, to pale chestnut. The animal possesses an erect, dark mane, which runs from the back of the head and along the neck. The mane is then followed by a dark brown strip running along the back to the root of the tail. Saline deserts, run. Arid grasslands and shrublands are preferred environments for their habitat. The seasonal waterlogging turns into ponds with the rainwater stowed in land depressions. These ponds in the sanctuary attract migratory birds, and a variety of different bird species can be found here. Pelicans and lesser flamingos can be seen in a large number here. Human habitats can also be seen here, and amongst them, the sizable tribe found here is that of Agarias, the salt pan workers. It is to be noted that this wildlife sanctuary has one of the largest salt pans in India. The undulating hills of Aravali, supporting the dry deciduous forests of North Gujarat, provide an unimaginably beautiful ambience here. It's breathtaking. This is a reserved forest that falls under the Balaram Ambuji Wildlife Sanctuary. This picturesque area was constituted as a wildlife sanctuary by the government of Gujarat on 7th August 1989 for the purpose of protection, propagation and development of wildlife and its environment, principally for protection of the sloth bear, which is now categorized as vulnerable on the IUCN Red List. Sloth bear is omnivorous, black and dark brown in color, with generally a yellowish patch on the chest. The sloth bear prefers biodiversity zones in the sanctuary that are rich in fruit trees and the presence of honey, ants, and termites. Their habitats can be dry forest or wet rain forest or grasslands with shrub trees and stones. This sanctuary is home to panthers, sloth bears, leopards, jaguars, foxes, hyenas, and lesser mammals, in addition to reptiles including crocodiles in the Banas River. The period from October to May is considered to be the best time to visit. Acres and acres of deciduous forest, grasslands, marshy swamps all combine to contribute to the rich wildlife in Gujarat. Wildlife in Gujarat is not restricted to national parks and sanctuaries, as resident and migratory birds frequent ponds, lakes and riversides in Gujarat cities. Whether you're a seasoned bird watcher or merely pursuing a hobby, there are many places in the state, some widely known, some less so. Some of the important bird sanctuaries of Gujarat are Marine National Park, Khejariya, Nal Sarovar, Thol, Porbandar Sanctuaries, Flamingo City, and Chari Dhand Conservation Reserve. Throughout most of the state, there is a naturally rich bird life. Peacocks and parrots are the most common. Migratory birds from North Eurasia find Gujarat a pleasant winter resting ground. The wetland complex is a lifeline for the community, as well as the wetland-dependent biodiversity, including both the flora and fauna. Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary is a spectacular natural lake with shallow waters and muddy lagoons dotted by 360 islets. It is the largest wetland bird sanctuary in Gujarat and one of the largest in India. It has been a bird sanctuary since April 1969 and a Ramsar site since 24th September 2012. It offers an ideal wintering ground for thousands of migratory birds. These birds travel tiring lengths from Central Asia, Europe, and Siberia to escape from the severe cold of the harsh winter there. Migratory birds start arriving here in October and stay till April. Their population reaches its peak in mid-winter. There are 360 islets in the lake. The sheer number of birds that is encountered in this beautiful place leaves the bird watchers spellbound. Both the flamingos, that is the lesser and the greater, inhabit Nal Sarovar. The former frequents the sanctuary during monsoon and post-monsoon periods, whereas the latter becomes abundant as the salinity increases after the monsoon. A very significant conservation value of Nal Sarovar lies in its large congregation of important migratory and local birds. Gosapra is a part of Tukra village in Porbandar district where fishermen families live along with some other communities. Gosapra is the main entrance of Mokar Sagar wetland as far as birding is concerned. Gosapra reservoir near Porbandar is home to a variety of bird species and is also nesting ground for waterfowls like demoiselle cranes and others. Roosts of greater and lesser flamingos, demoiselle cranes, common cranes, bar-headed geese, and grey-legged geese are found at Gosapra. Another important bird sanctuary, located near the coast of Jamnagar at a distance of 15 kilometers from the city, is Khejariya Bird Sanctuary. Amazingly, a large number of resident and migratory birds visit here, particularly during winters. Declared a sanctuary in May 1981, the sanctuary is spread over just 6.05 square kilometers. After Nal Sarovar, the state proposes Khejariya Bird Sanctuary to be declared as a Ramsar site. This diversity has a special conservation value as it has several globally threatened species such as Dalmatian pelican, darter, Asian open-billed stork, black-necked stork, black-headed ibis, Eurasian spoonbill, Pallas's fish eagle, pallid harrier, Indian skimmer, osprey, etc. Khejariya Bird Sanctuary is an outcome of two man-made structures. The earthen reclamation bunds in the midst of natural relief features have been constructed to arrest fresh water from draining into the sea and to arrest the salinity ingress from the seaside. Here, while you see seawater and related biodiversity on one side, you can watch freshwater and related biodiversity on the other, with some species sharing both. Human or natural, threats need to be mitigated before the damage reaches irreparable levels. With the development of infrastructure, also comes the disturbance and threat to wild animals. Roads passing through the sanctuary pose a threat of accidents for the animals. Rescue centers are located at various parks and sanctuaries of Gujarat. The special team of doctors and paramedical staff is always on call for rescue operations and medical treatments. This team is responsible for rescuing the injured animals and transporting them to the rescue center for medical attention. These centers are home not only to the injured animals. Many wild animals that stray into human colonies are also rescued and brought and kept here till they are ready to be set free in the jungles again. Apart from that, the orphaned or abandoned offsprings of many animals are kept here after rescuing them. They live here till they are grown enough to be shifted to a safe place which has none or lesser threats for them. Most of the sanctuaries and national parks have interpretation centers. These centers are used for different means of communication to enhance the understanding of the tourist and other visitors. These centers are created to aid and stimulate the discovery process and the visitor's intellectual and emotional connection to the wildlife and forests. Many interpretation centers have temporary exhibitions related to specific aspects. They work to educate and raise awareness. This serves to blend the continuity of scientific wildlife management with modern-day management options in order to achieve a desirable level of conservation and development of wildlife. Wildlife in Gujarat is very much protected even outside the national park and sanctuaries. It can be seen from examples of Black Buck National Park, Velavadar, Gair National Park landscape, the world's best conservation success story. Wild ass landscape and birds in various parts of Gujarat. Along with all the government initiatives of conservation, people of the state play a vital role in wildlife protection. Unfortunately, Gujarat state has always had wildlife as an integral part of its cultural and religious beliefs. This belief system has worked much towards people's contribution in protection of wildlife. With the government and the people working hand in hand, it's been a social, moral, political and cultural partnership for the conservation and protection of wildlife in Gujarat state. Bestowed with the thickest of jungles and largest of plains and grasslands, sentinel mountain ranges and meandering rivers and pristine lakes, Gujarat state has it all that takes to be an ecologically blessed region. Mesmerized by the play of nature, one can here immerse in the ambiguity and serenity of wilderness. In every nook and corner of the state, natural reserves are abound. Every bend of the road makes you hear the call of the wild.